I just wanted to make a quick video, and you'll have to excuse my voice. I'm a little under the weather. We have a major cold front coming this weekend, and we have the possibility of being in the mid-20s for three nights in a row. I have so much to do. But anyway, I just wanted to share with you something I learned yesterday that you might already know, but it was like revolutionary to me to really realize this. And it's made so much sense as to why I say Illinois Everbearing needs a zone 8 or lower, and others will say, well, no, Illinois Everbearing does good in 9 and 10, even 10. And then I think, well, maybe they don't have the same Illinois Everbearing as I have, because I'm quite positive that the problem here is it doesn't want to wake up or fruit when we don't have an extreme cold winter. Well, I just wanted to show you what everything should be asleep, and it is not trying to, but nothing much at all is asleep. So anyway, I was on the I was messaging Marta yesterday back and forth about mulberries, and we were talking about zones, and she said she's in zone 9B and I'm in zone 9B. But then she said she gets 800 to 1,000 chill hours. I'm like, you get 800 to 1,000 chill hours? Well, that's a massive difference when you're growing fruit trees. I don't know why I didn't ever put that together, that there was so much difference within chill hours of the same zone, because here, I would say even a really cold year, I'm not even sure we get 300 chill hours. So it makes total sense that the low chill stone fruit that I've purchased before and have planted out here, it never fruits and it hardly wakes up. Well, it's because of the chill hours. So the chill hours are so important, and I never realized that there was such a difference within the same zone. So really, unless there's already something out there that I didn't realize, it should be, you know, you're in zone 9B and chill hour zone 2 or whatever. That's such a major difference. And that is exactly why, yes, Illinois Everbearing could wake up in a 9B if you had 800 to 1,000 chill hours versus 300. So to me, that's pretty revolutionary, that I just did not realize that the chill hour difference was so massive. Really, I mean, so within a 9, if you were in a 9B and you could get 1,000 chill hours, you could almost pretty much grow any stone fruit. And here, no, not at all. Because really, I would say we really average maybe 250 chill hours. Like I said, except this year and last year, we've had a really cold winter and a really cold one coming up here. But anyway, I just wanted to share that and just show you a little bit of what's going on in the orchard. I've got so much that I'm going to have to cover because I've newly planted these mulberries, and their root system hasn't established enough and they are awake. So I've got to do something to protect them. So I'm fixing to do that and round my family up to help me. All right, well, have a great day, a wonderful Christmas. Plant lots of fruit trees. Central Florida zone 9B and 300 chill hours.